my god. He's pushing me into the door.
No! Leave me alone! Get away from me!
I still look like it. Now I look normal again. Oh, I'm about to shiv that kid.
The people here live a simple life. Try not to complicate.
Boo! So I've talked to her before, I just didn't... Oh, that's not where I want to go.
Careful. There are some dangerous areas around here that are not part of any tours.
So either there was another development, and now I could ask to help her, or I just never chose that option. So I never got the quest, and it never told me to stop. I never took it off activity.
Don't be afraid to do whatever you can to make that monster feel extra convincing. Just don't hurt anyone.
I didn't hurt anyone.
Hmm. Well, I can say the costume looks good on you.
Well, I scared off some tourists for you.
Oh, I'm glad it worked.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for indulging me with my weird ideas. Tell you what, if you want to come back later and do this for me a couple more times, I'll even let you keep the costume.
Come back later. Oh, she took it back, though.
You wouldn't believe how many off-worlders think hiking the surface of Titan is all fun and games. But a lot of thrill-seekers end up in my office.
Okay, well.
Be well.
That's it. Need to talk to more people now. Oh wait. Okay, well, it's not gonna show us exactly where, of course. Well, it's obviously up.
Whoa, did you see that weird monster thing? It nearly scared me off to death until I realized how fake it was.
Oh, damn.
Did you see those wind
turbines
out there?
I could have sworn I've seen those silly little space frog posters somewhere else. Never thought I'd see them here.
Fake? I'll show you. Not sure how, but I will.
Hello.
Hi. How are you doing? Oh! Energy system? I don't think I've ever been here. Energy systems office? Neat. History of the pirates. What's it take? Might have read this, I don't remember. The 1724 work, A General History of the Pirates, is a first-hand account of the lives and adventures of several swashbucklers who plied their trade in the Caribbean during the so-called Golden Age of Piracy. It was supposedly written by one Captain Charles Johnson, but there's no evidence that such a person actually existed. Instead, most people attribute the book to Daniel Defoe, famed author of Robinson... I thought it was Robinson Crusoe, writing under a pen name. The following is an excerpt. Chapter 3 of Captain Teach, alias Blackbeard. Edward Teach was a Bristol man born, but had sailed some time out of Jamaica in privateers in the late French War, yet though he had often distinguished himself for his uncommon boldness and personal courage, he was never raised to any command till he went a-pirating, which I think was at the latter end of the year 1716, when Captain Benjamin Hornigold put him into a sloop that he had made prize of, and with whom he continued in consortship till a little while before Hornigold surrendered. In the spring of the year 1717, Teach and Hornigold sailed from Providence for the main of America and took in their way a billop from the Havana with 120 barrels of flour as also a sloop from Bermuda, third bar master, from whom they took only some gallons of wine and then let him go, and a ship from Madeira to South Carolina, out of which they got plunder to a considerable value. After leaning on the coast of Virginia, they returned to the West Indies, and in the latitude of 24 made prize of a large French Guinea man bound to Martinico, by which by Hornigold's consent Teach went aboard of as captain and took a cruise in her. Hornigold returned with his sloop to Providence, where, at the arrival of Captain Rogers, the governor, he surrendered to mercy, pursuant to the king's proclamation. Interesting. Hi. You realize now that I am here. Oh, there's a slate.
That old Titan wind is going strong today.
I'm taking the slate. Equipment review from New Homestead Department of Energy. Wind turbines continue to ice up. They're the originals, and this being New Homestead and all, it seems fitting to keep them that way. Recommendation is to keep administering repairs. Replacing them, while sensible, is both costly and diminishes the classic appeal of New Homestead. As such, I will decline sending a proposal to the appropriate parties at the UC Energy Department. Bogdan Breda, Chief Power Technician. So she's gonna want new ones. She's gonna want new ones. They just want to repair the old ones.
Oh, hi. Hello there. Are you here about the brownouts?
No.
That's usually the only reason people come up here to talk to me, since I'm the power system manager here.
Mm-hmm. Well, no. What about the brownouts?
Yes, the power shortages we're experiencing. Haven't you seen the flickering lights?
Mm-mm.
This equipment is all very old, and the protections against the cold have worn down, so now? Brownouts. All the time. And I get to deal with it. Hooray for me.
You're in charge of all the power here? Get it? Charge?
Oh. Yep. I get it, all right. Yes, I'm in charge of the electrical power here. We generate a lot of wind-based power here on Titan, which is my specialty, so I was tapped to help navigate all the unique challenges we face here. Shocking, I know.
Mm-hmm. No, that does sound like a problem.
You have no idea. Worse, I'm stuck up here overseeing the whole system, and we don't currently have anyone available to go out there and take care of the problem.
Well, you do now. How does New Homestead get its electrical power? Right, you were saying wind turbines.
Did you see those huge wind turbines out there on your way in?
Yeah.
They're our primary source of power generation.
Mm-hmm.
Titan's strong winds provide an almost constant source of power, as long as we can keep the machinery from icing over.
Okay. What's it like working on the surface of Titan?
Well, I just started this job a few months ago, but I'm loving it, despite all the small frustrations of working on ancient equipment. I came here as a child and did one of the tours. I loved it so much, I jumped at the chance to come back after finishing my studies in energy science. I know it may sound unusual, but I knew what I was getting into with Titan's harsh surface. The challenge is actually one of the things that attracted me to the job.
You're insane. So you're not originally from New Homestead?
No. New Atlantis, born and raised. It's okay, though. I've always liked this quaint little moon. Not that it's actually that little as far as moons go. The people here were a little wary of someone coming in from the outside, but once I changed my name in accordance with their local customs, it went a long way to build trust.
You had to change your
name.
And
that was fine by me. I feel proud, taking on the name of the Earth City my family came from many, many years ago.
Guessing it'll be the last name, not Joyce. Maybe there's something I can do to help with the brownouts?
Actually, that's not a bad idea. I'm a little new to the job, and I'll admit I'm struggling a little bit. I could use some help.
What are you struggling with?
So I really want to impress everyone and show them I can handle this. But the power equipment is ancient and in need of replacement, if I'm being honest.
They won't replace it.
We just don't have the money and the budget right now to do it. The previous technician was adamant that it was better to repair than replace.
Hold on, that's late.
So he never submitted any replacement plans for budget considerations. We have to wait for next year.
Wow. Alright, tell me what you need.
I could use someone who's handy with a laser cutter to break up the ice that's formed on some of the power system machinery out there.
No problem.
That should clear up the shorts we've been experiencing and stop the brownouts. Does that sound like something you can do?
Yeah. I'll do it, but some payment better be involved.
Of course! I can spare some credits once the power comes back on full force after you clear the ice. Please, take care not to hurt yourself or damage the equipment while you're out there. I'll stay here and monitor the power systems. Thanks!
Okay. 5 ice deposits.
Careful not to damage the equipment with the cutter while you're working. We don't need any more problems.
Oh, is that something that can happen? Can you remind me what you need me to do?
I need you to remove the ice that's preventing the power equipment from working properly and causing these brownouts.
Right.
I'd suggest using a cutter to remove the ice, since it's pretty thick. You'll find the wind turbines and power transformers in the field nearby. Can't miss them.
I always ask them again, because it's a different voice acting lines and stuff.
Bye.
They say different things. Wow, that's cool. Because I had no idea that entire office was there.
Feel free to look around, but do not touch.
Touch whatever I feel like. Before I run outside... I keep defaulting to that. Let me look at this. It's another activity, I think, isn't it? Yeah, I'm not sure. Okay, let's speak with Luthor then. See where Luthor might be.
You get used to the methane processing smell after a while.
Oh, in here.
I'm learning so much here.
Hi. Everyone.
Hello there. Welcome to the new Homestead Chunks. We've got all your Chunks favorites. Well, almost all of them.
Almost.
Sadly, we're out of the special sauce. I know. But everything else is still that great Chunks food you know and love. So, what can I do for you?
What happened to the special sauce? Yeah, I guess I didn't talk to him at all. You really seem to love Chunks, huh?
You know I do. What's not to love? It's delicious, nutritious, easy, fast, inexpensive. It sure makes my hungry belly sing for joy.
I don't want to hear that.
My wife thinks I eat too much Chunks food, but I just can't help myself. It's so good.
Yeah, your stomach singing is not something I wish to encounter. So what's your favorite Chunk?
Oh, you had to go and ask the hard questions, huh?
It's starting off hard, yep.
How can I pick just one? Chicken Chunks, beef Chunks, potato Chunks, cheesesteak Chunks, cheesecake chunks, I... Hmm? You know what? I'm gonna cheat, if you don't mind, and just say I love them all equally.
No. Mm-hmm. Lame answer. Not accepted. Well, New Homestead is all about authentic living history. What's Chunks doing here?
Well, people gotta eat, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But seriously, I think we're just starting to get with the times a little. And I can't think of a better restaurant than Chunks to usher that in. I think corporate just saw New Homestead as an untapped market.
Yeah.
And the locals may not eat it, but the tourists love having a taste of home.
It's all because of capitalism. Your wife owns the Brown Horse Tavern. How could you work for the competition?
Don't let me. Oh, it's all good. Chunks pays me pretty well. And between you and me, Anya's doing all right herself.
That's good.
Plus, we got this plan, you know? We want to see if we can't introduce some of Anya's famous cooking to the Chunks lineup and pitch it to corporate. Imagine. Anya's delicious food in every Chunks restaurant across the settled systems. And people are bound to come visit her place to see where it all started. It's a win all around.
Okay. Well, running out of Chunks special sauce does sound like a problem.
If I'm completely honest, it is. And people are always saying how this Chunks can't compare to the real deal. And I just know it's because we never had that mouth-watering sauce. I've been in contact with some of the other restaurants out there, and they'll give me some. But they say they can't afford to send it, and I don't have a ship, so what am I to do?
Huh. Is there a reason Chunks doesn't just send you the sauce?
For real? Good question. They haven't said, but I think it has something to do with them prioritizing other Chunks over mine.
Probably.
I guess it's made at a different facility than our other food. And they don't even want to pay the shipping cost to ship from another store to ours. Mm. Sometimes I get lucky and a cargo hauler passes through with a route that takes them near other Chunks and back again. But there's no guarantee.
Yeah, because you're in an out-of-the-way place with not a lot of people here. So, yeah. See, they think even if we add the sauce, we're not going to make that much money because, well, what is there, like 30 people that live here or something? Is the sauce really that important? He just said it was, I know, but see what he says.
You bet it is. You may not hear people talk about it, but trust me, it's the secret ingredient. It's like the glue that holds it all together. I mean, not literally. I'm not saying it's glue or that our food falls apart. It's delightful. Tangy, savory, a little sweet, but not too sweet. And I've noticed that once people find out we don't have it, sometimes they don't return. It's the reason business isn't as good as other Chunks.
Wow. Well, if you just need someone to go get it, I could do that for you.
Wait, for real? You do that. You're not pulling my leg.
No leg pulling. Yeah, I'll do it if you pay me.
Oh, of course.
Oh.
Between what I've got personally and the petty cash, I'm sure I can get you what you deserve. So, I know of another Chunk that has a case of sauce ready to go for you. I actually cleared it with them just before you arrived. If you mention it to whoever's working the counter there, they'll hook you up. Bring it back here, we'll be golden. Thanks.
Which one?
Welcome to Chunks, home of the best Chunks in the settled systems.
About that special sauce I'm getting for you, I'd like to know where I'm going again. He actually didn't say. I'm sure it's in the log, though.
Oh, yeah, of course. Just head to that Fancy Pants Chunks in Paradiso.
Paradiso?
You want to talk to whoever's at the front counter about that case of sauce. They should be expecting you.
Okay. Paradiso.
Thanks for visiting Chunks.
No problemo. Special sauce. Oh, here's the, I didn't see that before. Did I just not... I swear this was like the top one. Anyway, I agreed to pick up a case of Chunks special sauce for Luther, the manager of the New Homestead Chunks. I'll need to speak with someone at the other Chunks restaurant he's sending me to. Paradiso. I don't know what that is. the Porama system? Well, I'm not going there yet. Joyce Osaka, New Hempstead's energy technician, asked me to help clear ice away from some of the power equipment out in the field and stop the brownouts. I should use a cutter to clear away the ice. Yeah, I still have my original one. Well, wouldn't I, right? That tells me to talk to the bartender. Who's Catherine Lucian? Oh, she's on Neon. You're not going back there, probably for a while.
If you need.
What?
Medical attention, see Dr. Lakota. But a word of warning, she really doesn't care for tourists.
What about ventriloquists? Does she
Boy,
like ventriloquists?
Am I glad they have chunks here.
Yeah, I know all about her tourist problem. Alright, I need to. Whoa. That's possessed. I must wear a spacesuit. Is it not on? None equipped. When did this stuff get unequipped? And why? I mean, I was outside here and that didn't happen. All right. So we need a mining laser. Cutter, whatever. I'm ready to begin. Am I gonna encounter any monsters? I think there are some heat leeches and stuff. Oh, cool. Just want to run up here, see what's up here. Nothing up here. Two to go. Okay, let's see. Whoops. In midair, I did it. One more. I'm gonna take the ice off the last one. All of a sudden, a bunch of monsters come out of nowhere. Start wailing on us. Well, this last one's far away. Well, when it says protection regen, you lose sight of the meter. Well, it does that. I thought the regen was like fixing my. I thought that was trouble. I'm expecting trouble. I'm a little jaded, you see. Great. Returning. Yeah, I like doing these little quests. I find the whole quest loop in Starfield to be enjoyable, entertaining. Granted, it's not the most amazing stuff ever, but it's fun.
Enjoy your visit here.
Thank you. So, yeah, whereas a game like Skyrim, for example, I would just explore all over and do quests, but with this, I'm just doing quests, because things are procedurally generated anyway, and I don't want to get stuff that's like, you know, the same thing over and over, is what tends to happen.
Hello there. The museum here is free to everyone.
Yes, I have perused it. Wait a second. Return to Joyce. I'm gonna go that way. But I don't think she's that way. I think she's this way.
If you take one of those stupid tours, make sure to follow the rules. They're for your own safety.
Oh, you're the doctor, never mind. Get my quests mixed up here. Never mind. I'm used to the pointer sometimes telling me the wrong way. It was telling me the right way, probably. Wait, wait. We need to take that elevator. That's right. I was heading back to the doctor. I'm like, wait, your name's not Joyce. I was wondering if she named herself after something on Earth.
Welcome to New Homestead.
I forgot what her last name is. Oh. Joyce?
I'm really glad you're helping us out.
Oh, Osaka. She named herself after the city of Osaka.
How's it going out there with the ice?
Well, the ice is all cleared out.
Great. I just saw the readings and everything looks good. Thank you. I hope it wasn't too much of a pain in the butt.
Mm-mm. It was easy. Easy money.
Some of the locals dislike tourists, but I love learning new insights from them.
Yeah, the doctor dislikes tourists.
Take care.
All right, that's great. I know she had the mining laser there, too. As a free take, in case you don't have one. check. Okay, I do have this stuff on. Oh, so that's pretty cool. We completed two quests that started here, and I like this, you know, small little one-and-done quests. Especially after you do a lot of big ones. It helps, you know, keep it fresh.
All right, let's get this crate into space.
I beg your pardon, do not call my beloved ship a crate. Alright, so I'm going to call in an episode here, and I'm not completely sure. We'll determine next episode what we're going to do. I'm not sure if I'm going back to the Bannock 4 and deal with that. I don't like the fact of having to fight UC Systef. But since they're my enemy, maybe I should help the enemy of my enemy. Right? So I didn't intend to be a pirate. But through circumstance, becoming one anyway. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.